Check, please.
Hey, welcome back. In this video, we're going to take a look at a couple tech stocks that we're in love with, HPQ, Dell, and Intel. We own some of these. We have shares of them. We have positions we've established, and we'll tell you why. We'll look at the financials. We'll have Mo show us all the trading charts, and we'll give a mindset, a value investing approach when we reach eight pillar companies like some of these. Should you dive right in or what steps you should take? Paul and Mo are here to guide you and I through the process of investing. Let's get after it. Paul, what do you think of these?
Thank you, Seth. Guys, follow us on Instagram. Everything Money Investing is our new account. It's growing like gangbusters. But also, don't forget to follow us personally, Seth, Mo, and I. We really, really, really need the ego boost. We've been shattered lately. Yes. I don't know why, but we have been shattered. We've all lost weight, though. Anyways, so guys, we're going to look at three tech companies today. Dell, Intel, HPQ, right? I think we're starting with HPQ.
Yeah, go ahead.
I own HPQ. I own Intel. I don't own Dell yet, but I think it intrigued me the other day when I looked at it for 2 seconds.
That's been making waves in the Everything Money community, you and your new love for Dell.
Well, I don't know if it's a new love, but it's there.
The morning show.
Yeah. All right, so guys, let's go to the eight pillars. This is our Everything Money software. More on that later. This is the eight pillars tool. Let's go to HP. HPQ is the ticker symbol. Now, I'm going to go straight to the eight pillars tab once we're done with this, but a few things I want to cover first. One, their market cap is $41 billion. So to buy all the equity in the business would be $41 billion. Dividend yield, 2.3%, almost double what the market is right now, which pays out $938 million. If you're new to our channel, dividends are not always secure. You have to compare the dividends paid to free cash flow. So right above it, we look at the free cash flow. Last 5 years, they've averaged $4.2 billion. Last year, $5.8 billion. They can easily afford this dividend. So go to the eight pillars tab. If you want to learn more about it, this is an eight pillar thriller, guys. This has all eight checks. That doesn't mean you go out and buy it. Everybody relax.
That's what I do, Paul.
I know you do, Seth. That's why you're broke.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just kidding. He's not broke. Seth is very wealthy.
Go on.
These have all the attributes that I like. Shares outstanding, decreasing, low debt, cash flow increase, low value to cash flow, low price to earnings, high return on invested capital, revenue growth, and net income growth. This is boring. This boring company is increasing its revenue, its net income, and its cash flow over the last 5 years. I don't know why people are missing this. I have no idea, but I'm a buyer.
I did joke around a bit there for a moment, but for our viewers at home, if you do see an eight pillar, there were times, Paul, in my younger years that I would see an eight pillar stock and just buy it.
Yes.
And then later I might say, I don't know why I'm in this. I don't know when I'm getting out. So there is an understanding prior to just, you know, there is a little more diligence you have to do here.
So there's a lot of due diligence. Understand the business, but this eight pillars is a great way to start looking at a company. Guess what? I own a stock that has all eight X marks. These are not a single green check, CCL. I own that. Because mm-hmm. It's not just about the check marks. One of the things we have to do, one of the most popular things we've done is we created a stock analyzer tool. So what this does is every investment is the present value of all future cash flow. So we created this because you have to make assumptions to determine what that cash flow is worth today. So you input your assumptions in the future and it spits out a price to pay for the stock today based on those assumptions. So let's go do that for HPQ. Stock analyzer tool. First things first, I'm picking the number of years to analyze, 1 to 20, I'm picking 10. Revenue. So they have revenue loss in the last 10 years. I think they sold off a lot of divisions. So let's just sit there and be conservative. 1, 2, and 3% revenue growth. Profit margin. I'm going to pick 6, 7, and 8%. Free cash flow margin, 7, 8, and 9%. PE, 8, 10, and 12. Actually, you know what? 10, 12, and 14. So I'm still being low compared to the overall market, because it's not a fast-growing company. And I do 12.5% return. Guys, I always do 12.5%. And the reason being is I can buy an ETF and make 9 or 10%. So in order for me to buy an individual stock, give me a reason to. Give me a higher return. Give me a bigger margin of safety. Very simple. Analyze. Look at this. Guys, middle range, 41 to 47. Low range is just barely above the low range of the low 30s, and the high range is a high 50s. That's my margin of safety number. I'm buying HPQ. I'm not saying for you to do it. Go understand the business. I've done a lot more research on it with 10K and things like that to understand it better. Now, next stock. Mo, do you want to do the HPQ chart actually?
Sure.
guys, if you want to not, if you want to ignore all fundamentals and just trade based on price, Mo will take it away.
It's much more fun. Go ahead, Mo.
Yeah, so I'm going to look at the daily chart first just to see what resistance points we're hitting. So right now we're just kind of hovering right on top of this 50-day moving average. So that 50-day moving average plus all of this good volume that we're seeing coming in, plus on the daily chart we're at the bottom here, maybe about to turn up. Now let's go over and correlate this to the long-term chart, because this to me is a slower moving stock, longer term hold, good trends. Actually, let's zoom out a little bit more. So look at this trend. This trend down took from June through until we popped up again November. So I really like companies like this that can come down, take a very long time, go on the bottom. This is a short, and as the price declines, same going back up, takes a long time. We're in the overbought area. As we go sideways up here, this keeps moving up. To me, wait until this thing breaks out to a new all-time high over maybe $40, whatever it is, and go at it. This is a good-looking stock. Good stock, even if you don't do it today, put this in your portfolio for a long-term watch.
Paul, tell me about Dell, baby.
All right, so Dell, guys. Dell is something interesting, had a big jump up recently. If you guys remember the history of Dell, it's only been public for a few years now. It was the golden child of the 1990s. People were loving Dell. It's if you're stupid if you don't have Dell in your portfolio. Then it started to plummet. At one point, it was selling for 9x earnings. Dell decided to go private because they didn't want to sit there and be a slave to the quarterly earnings. They went private, rebuilt the business, came back public. Michael Dell, I think, is worth $60 billion, the most quiet $60 billion you never heard about in your entire life. So,
yeah, that is true.
$45 billion, no dividends. So let's just go right to the eight pillars tab. So I like this low free cash flow. Now, it's not consistent with the PE, so you have to go find out why the PE is so much higher than the price of free cash flow, or find out why the price of free cash flow is so much lower than the PE. So I'm immediately going to go to the income statement to figure this out. Net income, okay, doesn't look like it's anything standing out there to me. Actually, let's see one thing. Other special income, they had a $4 billion extra income last year. Let's see cash flow, free cash flow. Has been pretty consistent and growing. Okay, interesting. So let's go to the stock analyzer tool. They have a lot of debt here, though. 8x free cash flow, 5-year free cash flow for debt. They have $50 billion in debt. That seems like a lot.
Yeah.
That seems like a lot. Their market cap's 44.8, and they have $50 billion in debt.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, okay. All right, so let's go to Stock Analyzer tool. Let's do a 10-year analysis. Revenue growth, 2, 3, and 4%. Actually, 2, 4, and 6%. Profit margin, this was kind of hard. Let's go with 3, 4, and 5%. Free cash flow, let's go 6, 7, and 8%. PE, 10, 12, 14, free cash flow, 10, 12, 14, 12.5% return like before, analyze, and this is why it was attractive. I mean, it's all over the board because of the wide range difference between earnings and free cash flow, but we have a low price of basically, the stock is in between the lowest two areas, 40 to 80, and the high price of 100 to 160, so it's $130 average, so we got basically $60 average here, $90 average here, and $130 here. So it's selling for all below every single average. Jeez. This might be something to look at.
But you want to understand the debt first.
But I want to understand the debt first. I want to understand more about the company. Why don't they have consistent earnings? Why not consistent profit? They don't have a long track record since going public again. You've got to understand these components because debt is exactly to a company like it is for people.
Well, what about trading, Dell?
Yeah, Dell is actually looking pretty good too. It's funny, these companies that are the quote-unquote dinosaurs, like I call them. So let me pull this up on a daily chart just to show you. What I love right here, we're sitting on top of all four major moving averages. So all that resistance is out of the way. We are trending down right now, but I think the trend is going to come down, bounce off of one of these two moving averages, 50 or 25, and just roll right back up. Just like what was the other company we just said, HP is going to do. And all you would do is wait because you are approaching these all-time highs or 52-week highs, whatever they are, wait for some engulfing candlesticks to break out, add at a new all-time high, and your stochastic is fine. It's a little overbought, but it's not super concerning. When you're this overbought, just make sure you're adding on all-time highs, and you'll be fine, or 52-week highs.
Paul, last company we're going to look at is, I have no clue, I forgot. It's Intel. Of course. How could I forget? I was just looking at my returns on Intel, which are really nice.
All right. So, guys, Intel, full disclosure, I've built a position in Intel. I've been talking about Intel. I started buying it when it was in its upper 40s. I still sell puts sub 50 on Intel. So, Intel, one of the things about Intel is look at their dividend. They pay out a 2.6% dividend that eats up 5.6% that they can easily afford because their five-year average is $15.7 billion in free cash flow. So that dividend looks pretty safe. Very good return on invested capital. Let's go to the eight pillars tab. Eight pillar thriller, guys. All eight check marks. Low PE, low price of free cash flow, low debt, buying back shares, growing cash flow, growing net income, growing revenue. I mean, come on.
Boring.
Yeah, boring loser company that's going nowhere and everything is growing. I don't get it. So I'm buying Intel. I'm hoping it's like Microsoft in 2011 and 12. Everybody said it was boring and stupid and lame. And then the world smartened up. Stock analyzer tool. Go right into it. I'm going to be very conservative on Intel. I'm going to do -1, 0, and 1% revenue growth. Profit margin, I'm going to do 23, 24, and 25%. Free cash flow margin, 20, 21, and 22. PE, 10, 12, 14, 10, 12, 14. 12, and I'm being very conservative here, guys. I'm not even trying to be sexy. I just want to show you how good it is.
We can see that with your clothes.
Now, you sit there and say, Paul, this is all red, but look how low I was on PE. These are not reasonable PEs. Why are you laughing, Mo?
You didn't hear what he just said.
Oh, what'd you say?
Nothing.
He said, I'm not trying to be sexy here. And he said, yeah, we could see that with your clothes.
Hey, what's wrong with
I know. You look, actually, you look like a straight pimp today with them pants. I mean, you're looking great. I'm telling you, know that.
We need to start getting some clothing endorsements here.
You love this shirt.
I do.
There's something about it.
I have like six of these.
Yeah, like the patch. Anyway, get back to Intel. I interrupted you. Go ahead.
I'm also very svelte. So you might sit there and go, Paul, these are all red numbers. Yeah, I think I'm being ultra, ultra conservative on these PEs and margins and everything like that and revenue growth. I mean, guys, to me, I look at this company saying, this is a major brand that I think is going to turn around. AMD is not what I think it's. Everybody said it's been saying that about AMD for 20 years that they're going to kill Intel. I mean, the world chip market is growing like crazy, and they're the leader. And they're going to they can manage. They're building a $20 billion factory here in Ohio that's going to employ 3,000 people.
We should all go submit our resumes.
We should all get a tour, maybe.
That'd be nice. You're right.
Yeah,
of course.
I think Seth Klarman owns a lot of Intel.
I got one.
Go ahead, Mo.
I got a good one. Somebody told me about this morning on the morning show. So Intel is coming out with a chip that's going to be used for Bitcoin mining, and it's going to make it more eco-friendly. So,
exciting stuff.
Exciting, I mean, disruptive stuff. Intel's back, baby.
Oh, wow, look at this, Paul. So the super investors out there, the ownership count is at 10. Look at this, Paul. Lots of buys on Intel. Seth Klarman. Actually, he's reducing his Intel now that I look at it. But
oh, wow, that's surprising.
But anyway, lots of people own this, so.
All right. So, guys, that's what I look at Intel. Mo, do you want to talk about the chart?
Yeah, Mo, you want to trade this?
Yeah, so the hardest thing for me about it, right now Intel is just below, just under its 200-day moving average. I would just wait for this thing to pop back up. But here's the thing. They report earnings on January 26th. Be careful with Intel's earnings. This is, look, if we just zoom out, I don't know how far I'm zoomed out right here, October of 2020. Gap on earnings, gap on earnings, gap on earnings. So it moves so much on earnings. You're going to gap one direction or the other. So here's the thing. Do not be in Intel if you're trading it on earnings. You're going to get, there's a chance you get really lucky. There's a chance you get really burned. So if you're trading it, do not be in it. If it's from a value play, stay in it and ride the wave.
If you're interested in these numbers, you can have them in the palm of your hand in your phone. Paul, show them how they can get the software.
So guys, we created the software because our subscribers were sick of waiting for us to make videos and they wanted to be able to analyze their own stocks on their own. So we created the software. We put it all on your mobile phone. So everything you saw in the video is available on your mobile phone in full. You get 30 years of financial data. You get access to Seth, Mo, and I. You get the full eight pillar analysis. You get the full stock analyzer tool. And then you also get everything that's coming right here. Everything down here. Exclusive video content only for our subscribers, the chat community with all of our users, and access to Seth, Mo, and I. This is all available for only $1 per day. That's it. $1 per day if you can just increase your gains by 1% or 2% or decreases your losses by 1% or 2% each year. This will lead to hundreds of thousands, if not millions, in your portfolio at some point in the future when you retire. And this is a no-brainer, $1 per day. You're locked in at the price. There are two ways to sign up, everythingmoney.com or Patreon. The benefit of everythingmoney.com is we're not large enough yet to charge a sales tax, so you get to save the sales tax for the time being. So again, guys, $1 per day gets you locked in, leads to hundreds of thousands, if not millions. No-brainer, sign up.
That is our take on these eight pillar companies. Obviously, we love them. They're not instant buys, but they're definitely frothy, Paul. We like that. So
yep.
Stay tuned, watch more videos, join the community, the link's below, and I will see you next video. Thanks.